Hi, this is Chris Whiting from WineGroover. I'm here today at Robert Channon Wines, as you can see. Great story here. Not only are they making a Verdelho and a Chardonnay that are winning awards and garnering a lot of positive response, it's a great story here. Imagine if you're starting up a winery and you're being sued all of a sudden by one of the largest wine companies in the world before you've even produced a bottle. That's what happened here. Let's hear his story. I'm here with Robert Channon from Robert Channon Wines, one of the leading stars here on the Granite Belt. Robert, tell us a bit about yourself. You've got a great setup here and it looks beautiful, but you weren't always a winemaker. You came from a different life before.
No, my previous life was, I was a solicitor. My wife Peggy was a teacher. My normal rationale for, you know, my normal explanation is to say that we were driven to drink by clients for so long that it was cheaper to make it instead. So we decided that we needed something a little bit quieter. And so a vineyard just seemed like an awfully good idea. We started out in a small way, and as these things always do, it grew like topsy. Mm-hmm. And now we only work 8 days a week instead.
One of the biggest claims to fame you've got, besides the quality of your wine, is the famed case where one of the world's giants decided to focus their attention on you here at the Granite Belt.
Look, we were terribly lucky. Before we even started, before we'd bottled our first vintage, we hadn't even printed our first label. And Moet and Chandon, the champagne people, decided that they didn't like my name Channon, and they'd try and stop us. So we started out my new life as a winemaker with a lawsuit, which was straight back to my old life, of course. But it was actually the best thing that ever happened to us. We got marvellous publicity. Mm-hmm. It launched us in a way that we could never have achieved otherwise.
You've also gathered many awards over recent years as well. What's the wine that you're most proudest of?
The Reserve Chardonnay, I think, is the only wine from the Granite Belt that has won a national trophy in a national show. It picked up the trophy for the best Chardonnay in the Brisbane show a few years ago. The Verdelho has been very kindly reviewed by James Halliday a few times. And the Verdelho actually is another story, because our name has been very much linked with Verdelho ever since we started because of our luck with it. But we actually never intended to plant Verdelho. When we laid out our first vineyard over there, I'd actually ordered Chardonnay as our one white grape.
Okay.
And when we went along to the nursery to pick up our Chardonnay, because we were little and insignificant, they sold our Chardonnay to somebody more important. And the only thing they had left was Verdelho. So we took home this Verdelho, planted it, and it won the trophy for Queensland's best white wine for the first 3 years. And Halliday rated it up as the best Verdelho he'd ever tasted. So.
Just as I left, a busload of older tourists arrived. Robert Channon put on his wry smile and went out to probably repeat his story again. From a lawyer to winemaker, Robert Channon juggles everything from promotions to restaurant management, yet he somehow still finds time to produce some sumptuous wines.